Azure Monitor now includes log analytics and application insights for full stack end-to-end monitoring to optimize the health and performance of your cloud or on-premises resources and applications. Rahul Bagaria is here to show us how today on Azure Friday. Today on Azure Friday, we'll be talking about Azure Monitor, and I have Rahul Bagaria, Product Manager for Azure Monitor, to show us some of the great new announcements that we're making at Ignite this week. So what do you want to show us? How have you made Azure Monitor just all that much better?
Yes, definitely. So we announced Azure Monitor as a new full-stack unified monitoring solution that you can use to monitor your applications, AKS containers, virtual machines, even get full-stack visibility across your resource groups, and then actually drill down to the actual line of code where potentially the problem lies, fix it, and impress your customers.
Fantastic. Well, what would you like to show us? What are some of the things that that are new?
So let me show you a workflow of how Azure Monitor looks today. So Azure Monitor, basically you can collect data from your applications, from your infrastructure, be it containers or virtual machines or network. And these could be on-premises resources. These could be on Azure, third-party cloud provider. You could even send any custom data through our APIs. Now all of that comes to our metrics or our logs database, which is basically raw telemetry. And then there are solutions built on top of that, which can give you more insights, diagnostics, visualizations, whatever you want. So if you have used Application Insights in the past, Application Insights is now a feature of Azure Monitor. And similarly, we have insights for containers, for virtual machines, and there are solutions for SQL storage and so on.
So Azure Monitor, as you said, now includes App Insights, Application Insights, as well as log analytics. And yep. So it's a single pane of glass, that single tool that you can use to manage all of your telemetry and health and monitoring data.
Yes. So these capabilities are now features of Azure Monitor. So think of it like a monitoring hub mm-hmm. within Azure Portal, where you can go look at all of your applications, containers, VMs, and figure out which ones are having any kinds of problems, drill down into that, and get more information.
Great. Let's see how this works.
Definitely. So let's get to Azure Portal. And here I have, here I am on the Azure Monitor blade. And there is overview, there is alerts, metrics, and logs, like one single experience. So you have data coming in from, as I said, your mm-hmm. apps or VMs or containers. Everything comes into one single place. So one place to set up your alerts, one place to capture your metrics and create charts, and one place to write your log analytics queries.
Great.
So in the insights column, you see there are a bunch of hero solutions like virtual machines, app insights, containers, network. So these are our customized solutions for particular scenarios. Right now, I am in virtual machines area, which is our new capability that we just launched. So you see there is a new concept of health here for virtual mm-hmm. machines. Now you can capture both host level health performance and your guest level health. Okay. So you can figure out which of your VMs are in critical conditions, drill down into that, figure out what's going wrong, maybe connect to the VM and try and fix that.
And you can customize when something is coming back as having poor health. What would define that as a poor health condition?
So right now, these are out-of-the-box criteria, but that's certainly in the roadmap that you can customize what a health condition means to you.
Great.
So let me show you how something like a health condition looks today. So in the table here, you look at, we have two kinds of OS. There is Windows and Ubuntu. And incidentally, all of my VMs are in critical condition.
Okay.
So let's click on the Windows VM and see what's going on. So here I am in Windows VM. So these are the bunch of different VMs I'm running on my workspace, and all of them are in critical case. So I'll just click on one of the critical issues and see what's going on, and I have that opened here. So here I can see for that particular VM, this is my entire health criteria, what's happening across my disk from my operating system, browser side, browser health, and so on. Now, it clearly tells me that my e-disk space, it's been mm-hmm. completely eaten up. I can just connect to the VM and maybe restart it or delete some resources from there and get my VM in a healthy state again.
Great.
So that was the health criteria. Let's get back to the VM blade. There is another tab you'll notice here that's performance. Now, performance is basically where you are tracking the performance of all of your VMs in one single place. So I've just selected, let's say, the resource group I want to track. And once I select that, I'll see all my perf counters from the VMs, like CPU, memory, bytes, and disk space, everything in one single view. Now, you'll notice here in the CPU utilization, one of the VMs have suddenly started spiking up in the last few hours, and it's taking up 90% of the CPU. That's certainly an unhealthy condition. So I can just jump onto the list view to see which that particular VM was. So this is Contoso Web 1 VM that's recently started spiking. I can just click on that, go to log events, and click on perf to open up the raw log analytics telemetry data and do some root cause analysis using queries.
Great, great. And I see that you can also set up alerts right from here as well.
Yes, I can set up alerts. I can track what the alerts are, edit them. And as I said, it's one single place. So you can set up your criteria ranging across VMs and apps and containers, multi-resource, multi-time series criteria, however you want to customize.
Okay, okay. How would you set up that query then?
So if I just click on perf, I go to the logs experience. And if you have used log analytics in the past, this is log analytics portal embedded just directly into Azure Monitor.
Oh, nice.
Now.
So you don't have to go to a whole separate tool anymore.
There is no separate portal. Everything is part of Azure Portal. Everything is inbuilt into Azure Monitor.
Okay, and it has that very SQL-like syntax.
Yep.
Does it include IntelliSense?
It has IntelliSense. Great. If you have used PowerShell or SQL, it's it should be very comfortable for you.
Great.
And on the left-hand side, you can see like it's not just data from VMs. Any data that you are collecting, security, management, monitoring, even any custom data sources you want to send, everything can be captured here. You can write queries, correlate across various different data sources, and get insights.
I love that. Okay.
So, for example, when I clicked on the perf counters, here I just got a simple query saying, show me all the perf counters on this particular VM. And this is the table which shows me all the data I was capturing. Great, but I would need to do something for root cause analysis, right? So I have a saved query. I don't want to type a bunch of lines of code here, but I have a saved query where I'm just building on top of those perf counters and just asking a simple question saying, I don't care about all the perf counters. Show me only the percentage processor time or the CPU time and split that by process name. So I know which process is eating up all the CPU that I can fix.
And you're looking at a very specific point in time as well to try and drill into when you were having the performance problem.
Yes, so in this case, I have just limited it to past 2 hours. I can extend it to 24 hours, 30 days, however I want.
Okay.
So I'll just run this simple query. Just takes a few seconds. So even if it's like terabytes of data, billions of data points, typically your average queries would just take single digit seconds to run through.
Okay.
So when it ran, if I look at the visualization below, I can see that there was certainly a process that was taking up, in this case, 160% of the CPU.
Mm-hmm.
It's a two-core process, so don't be alarmed by 150%.
Okay, yeah.
And if I hover on top of that, you see it's called W3WP. And for VM administrators, they would know this is the IIS process.
Right.
And it means there is some application that's eating up all the CPU. Maybe there is a noisy neighbor that's impacting the health. And I can then just go to the VM, just restart it, and be done with it.
Okay.
And one of the interesting things here is, now, we were able to manually identify and fix this issue right now. But what if it happens again? Right. We know this is something happening, I can go to the alerts and even automate the resolution. I can say that whenever this happens in future, just restart my VM. So I can run an automation
or run some other script that might do something to minimize the downtime.
Yep.
Great.
I don't have to be manually resolving issues all the time. I can set up automation, I can set up auto-scaling to basically take the load off my work stream.
Great, okay. Great.
Yeah.
Well, what more do you want to show us?
So that was the log analytics capability. If I get back to the VM blade, you see there is the third capability here, which is map. So if you have used OMS service map in the past, we have built-in service map capability right within Azure Monitor as well. So you can get a full visualization picture of all of your virtual machines, what they connect to, what ports are opened, and if there are any critical processes that you might want to drill down further. So I'm just opening up my workspace where the system lies. So you see here, I can get the full map of my virtual machine. So this is the VM that we were tracking. I can expand it and see all the different processes that were running on the VM. I can get more details. I can see what ports they were connected to. I can get full perf metrics about my VM and so on.
Okay.
So that's the service map capability built right into Azure Monitor.
Okay.
So we saw virtual machines. This is a completely new capability that we have. Let's look at some containers health.
That's becoming more and more important.
Definitely. So we either see like people have monolithic apps deployed on VMs, or many teams are now transitioning to microservices deployed on containers. So we have now fully supported AKS containers. And if you have Azure Monitor enabled for that, you just come to Azure Monitor, click on the Containers tab, and you get a new multi-cluster health view.
Okay.
So you would have multiple clusters of containers running, and in this one single place, you can look at the health of all of your containers. Now, for example, here I have this one particular cluster which is showing some warning status. Okay. I don't know what that is. I can just click on that particular cluster and jump onto the performance view of that cluster. So here I can see the node utilization, memory, node count, activity count, and here I see that one of the particular pods is in a pending state that I know is not good. Something is certainly wrong there. And my CPU utilization is also at 60%, which may or may not be good. Let me jump onto controllers to see what's happening right here. So in controllers, I see most of my controllers are fine, but this one particular controller where I'm running Minecraft, it has had 274 restarts,
okay,
and everything is red.
Okay.
That's certainly indicative of a problem, right?
Especially if you play Minecraft.
Definitely. So I just expand that controller, and I see all the pods that are running there. And this particular one, for example, it is in a warning state and 67 restarts. And if I go on the right-hand side and see the properties, let's do that again. I see container limits and requests, and I can see here that I had set up a limit of 10 microcores, and it's requesting 10 microcores, so it's completely at the limit,
right.
And I know 10 microcores is way, way too less. So somebody just misconfigured it. I can go to kubectl and kind of reconfigure my containers and be happy, play
okay.
Minecraft again.
And similar to the VMs, you can set up alerts, and you can automate responses once you get to a point where things you understand how things should be responding.
Definitely. And you could connect it to your ITSM tools, your
okay.
logic apps, your like any kinds of workflows or DevOps processes you are using today.
Great.
Yeah. So this was all the infrastructure side. We have developers listening to this as well. Let's see how you can jump onto the application layer and figure out what's going wrong. So here I am in application map, and this is a typical modern application, a multi-component application which has some front-end talking to some API, some back-end processing engine, which has a bunch of dependencies, like in this case SQL and Redis cache and a bunch of different tools. And incidentally, this particular application, it has .NET Core, Java, Node, bunch of different programming languages, different teams build different components,
mm-hmm.
and I can get a single topology view across my entire application architecture.
Okay.
So I can figure out where calls are going, what's in an unhealthy state, and I can then drill down further. So here I can see this particular processing worker. It has had 12% failures, and I can just click on it, look at all the failing requests, slow requests, and some contextual insights. Now this particular thing, there has been a failed request. I can just click on that and jump onto the failures experience, where I can track all of the failures of this particular type, and just click on operations to look at a particular sample. So I just clicked on a sample, and what comes here is now an end-to-end distributed tracing view. So typically what happens, you click on a button, it calls something in the backend, which calls a bunch of dependencies, maybe some APIs, and usually there is a multi-hop transaction.
Right.
Here, in one single place, you can track your entire transaction from the button click mm-hmm. to whatever happened at the end, maybe an exception in this case.
Okay.
And you can kind of pinpoint where the problem was in that entire transaction trace.
Absolutely. So you can start seeing not just where the exception happened, but what caused the exception leading up to that event.
Exactly.
Great.
Exactly. So if you are on the exception, you can see the full call stack, what was the message, failed method, and everything. And if you are using .NET-based applications, you could even open that snapshot or a dump file in Visual Studio, jump to the line of code and fix that problem then and there.
Great, great. So it's bringing all of this together under one umbrella.
Yes.
Great, great. Is there anything more?
So you could, of course, connect it with your DevOps processes. So here I have, like, if I'm not the developer, I can connect it to my work item management system and file it as a work item. Or if I'm using release management in Azure DevOps, I can just make it part of my release processes. So if there is an alert, if there is a performance problem, it just won't let the release go through from canary to production, for example.
Right.
So monitoring becomes a part of my daily processes rather than something I go when something breaks and then figure out what went wrong.
Right. Great, great. Well, thank you very much for joining us today. I can see that Azure Monitor has really brought in some of the best tools and services that allow you to more easily manage all of your health, all of your end-to-end health and performance of your applications. Look forward to putting this into action with my applications.
Definitely.
Thank you. We've been learning all about Azure Monitor today on Azure Friday.